Alright, ladies and gentlemen, in this video, we're going to look at how to create this magic wand effect that has these long, beautiful fairy dust particle trails. So without further ado, let's go ahead and have a look. Okay, so we have our footage here, and the first thing we're going to do is to turn our video into a Fusion clip, and then we're going to take our Fusion clip straight to the Fusion page. The first thing we're going to do here is to bring in a background as well as B-spline masking node. So the idea is that we want to create a path along the ballerina's hand where all the particles will be generated. So let's first of all go to right click for shape animation and then remove B-spline polyline. This will allow us to create a single path throughout this entire video. Now at this point we can pretty much get started with creating this path. So let's start to draw out this path as we move along this video. The path itself doesn't have to be perfect. It just needs to follow the movement of the hand so that the particles themselves can look like they're following the hand as the hand moves in the video. So now let's pipe the background node back to media in one, and we're going to go to B-spline, bring up the border width just a little bit there, bring down the length setting, and then we're going to use the position setting to animate this region where all the particles pretty much will be generated from. So now to animate this, let's come to the beginning of this video. Let's keyframe the position setting. We're going to type in -1 so that this region is going to completely disappear from this path. Then we're going to bring it back up towards 0. So we want it to start right before it shows up on the path. Okay, let's now start just the keyframing as we move along the video so that it follows the ballerina's hand. And at the very end, we're going to hit 1, but that's not going to make the region disappear completely. So we're going to add 0.01. So now as you can see, we have a perfectly animated region that follows the ballerina's hand. And this is also where all the particles will be coming from. Now, speaking of particle goodness, let's come to particles and let's bring in the emitter as well as the render node. And we're going to first of all come to emitter and then go to region. Let's change it to bitmap. And then we're going to connect what we created earlier to the emitter node. And then let's connect the render node to the merge node as the foreground. So if we look at the particle trails right now on the viewer, we can sort of see the particles in the region, but they're not very easy to detect. So let's come to the emitter node. Let's go to style and change from point to blob. Let's crank up the size setting, bring up size variance a little bit there. We're also going to add a fading and fade out. So just bring up both a little bit. We're also going to mess with size over life. This will allow the particle's size to change over its lifetime so that it's not constantly the same. Now under controls, we're going to bring down lifespan, but bring up numbers to about 20. We can also change temporal distribution to random. Now let's come back to style. One last thing we can do there is to change the color of the particles. I'm going to go with something warm, but you guys can choose whatever color you prefer. But one thing I do want to use is color over life. So we're going to click anywhere on the scale to add another point. But the idea is that we're going to have this color to start off with the same color as above, but eventually fade into white over the particle's lifetime. One thing the particles are lacking at this point is movement. They look kind of just blah. So before we do that, let's actually make a copy of all these nodes first, because we're going to reuse them later on. So let's bring a pflock node. And let's just bring up the repel strength setting just a little bit, just a touch. But what this will do, as you can see, is to allow the particles to disperse, and it's going to create a more natural movement, more natural look as the particles move across the space. All right, let's paste what we just copied earlier and connect this to the previous render node. We're going to look at this new render node, and the idea here is that we want to create a new layer to our overall composition. So we're going to play with the blur as well as the glow setting. This will add sort of a aura, nice aura to the particles themselves. So if we look at the merge node, we can see that this has a nice glowy effect. And we can also go back to emitter and go to the lifespan, play with that, change up the position variance, and we can also come to style, play with the fade controls, the fade out, as well as the size setting. And the idea is that we just want to add this nice glowy path to the particles that we just created. Okay, so let's paste once again, and we're going to connect it to the previous merge node, and then let's project this new render node onto the viewer. And here, the idea is that we want to add more movements. So let's bring in a turbulence node as well as the directional force node. And right off the bat, we can see that the directional force is way too strong. It's dragging everything down. So let's bring the strength setting down to zero and then just bring it up a touch. And this, as you can see, is a lot better. But still, we have to work on this movement. So let's come to turbulence. Let's bring up the density. This is not going to change the turbulence force, but it's going to make it look more natural. All right, we can also play with the strength over life setting. So we don't want it to start off too strong. We want it to start off slow and then finish strong. So now, as you can see, these particles are not only moving along the path, but also they have a really nice natural movement. All right, let's project merge node onto the viewer. And then we can also come to the emitter node and play with the position variance setting as well as the lifespan settings. But the idea here, guys, is just to enhance this overall look. It's looking pretty good right now, but we're going to for sure come back to some of these settings later on. Okay, let's paste one last time, connect everything to the merge node, and we're going to create the little stars that will be coming out of the fairy dust. So let's project render node onto the viewer. Let's go to emitter, and under style, let's change from blob to n-gon. And then first thing we're gonna do here is to change the size from 5 to 4. We're going to manually override the size setting to 2. Let's also crank up the size variance setting, and let's bring up fade out. And then under controls, we're going to first of all change the number setting from 20 down to 2. Let's also change the lifespan from 40 to 50. And under spin, let's go to the Z setting and then type in 100. This, as you see, will add a nice spinning motion to the particles as they move. Okay, now let's just add some movement to this. So let's bring in turbulence, bring up density a little bit there. And yeah, this is adding a nice smooth movement to it. So let's look at the overall merge node. So it's looking pretty good. And at this point, we can also add a soft glow to the stars. So let's do that. This, as you can see, not only adds a nice glow to the stars themselves, but also adds a nice glow to the overall effect. At this point, guys, we're pretty much done. So if we look at the overall effect, it's looking pretty good, but I definitely want to continue to polish this look. So let's come to this last emitter node. Under style, let's just start with color first of all. We're going to apply that also to color over life. And then we can also play with the alpha setting as well to see if that's going to kind of add more oomph to the colors. Yeah, that's looking good. We can also change size over life. And yeah, this is definitely going to make the colors pop. So this is looking pretty good. So I think we're going to stick with this for now. Now let's go to the previous emitter node, and we're going to do similar things here. So let's start with color adjustments, make the same changes to color over life. And of course, we're also going to play with alpha setting. Alpha settings, from my experience, they definitely do make a difference, but they're very subtle. Okay, now let's also mess with size over life. This, as we saw earlier, is definitely going to make a much bigger difference. So yeah, overall, it's definitely getting more and more polished. Now let's go back to the second emitter node. We're going to make some changes to size over life. We're going to skip colors for now. The same with the first emitter node. We're just going to focus on size over life. And this effect right now, when combined with the background video, is looking a lot better. The colors themselves definitely stand out more. And yeah, we can continue to work on this. Let's come to soft glow node. Let's make some small changes to the gain setting. We can also go back to all these emitter nodes and once again, change up size over life, which seems to, from what we've seen, have a pretty impactful effect on the overall look. But this is really coming together, and we are ready at this point just to bring this back to the edit page, let it render. So yeah, I really like how this fairy dust is coming on and trailing off nice and slow. It really goes well with the magical vibe. And from this point on, feel free to skip the rest of this video, because all we're going to do now is just to make some small tweaks here and there to this effect. Okay, so let's take our effect back to the Fusion page. So the first thing I think I want to work on here is the glow of the stars. So we're gonna go to the soft glow node and start messing with the gain settings there, just to bring that down a little bit. And we're also gonna go to the emitter node and focus on, once again, size over life, change that up a little. And then we're gonna go back to the third emitter node and once again, I'll make some changes to size over life as well as color. But the one thing I want to mention, guys, is that you don't necessarily have to follow exactly what I'm doing here. Feel free to experiment. You know, I'm going to really primarily focus on the emitter nodes and really focus on size over life, as well as the color, the size variance, and what have you. But there are also settings, other settings that you can try out and see what kind of look that you can get. You never know, right? So yeah, at this point, I think I'm okay with this so far. So let's take this back to the edit page, let this effect render. And one thing I do have to say, guys, I think while it looks good, certain areas seem just too exposed. So that's what I want to work on next, which is to find that sweet spot. So with that said, let's once again take our effect back to the Fusion page. And I think, just like what we did earlier, I want to focus on these emitter nodes and then focus on the colors as well as, you know, the size over life, which, as we've already seen, is a setting that I think is going to have a much better impact on the overall look. But there's also going to be a lot of back and forth with this. So it's hard to say, you know, exactly at what point it's going to look the best, but it's just going to be a lot of adjustment, a lot of tweaks, as you can see, for all these nodes. But yeah, at this point, guys, I think, you know, it's really looking a lot better. I just don't want it to be too overexposed, but I also don't want it to be too dark, too dim either. But yeah, so this overall look is really coming together. So let's just take this back to the edit page, let this effect render. I think this time around, this effect is looking a lot better. I really like the exposure. It's not as overexposed as it used to be. Yeah, so we're gonna go with this. This is a long video. I apologize, guys, but I do hope you enjoy it. I hope you learned something from this. And as always, I will see you next time.